Hello and welcome to Compare Two Columns in Excel. My name's Jeff, I'm glad you're here. Let's just jump right in. In this short video, we're gonna take a look at a couple of different situations where we can compare two columns. First, we're gonna look at some single column lists. Second, we're gonna look at lists with multiple columns. And finally, we're gonna look at comparing multiple tables even when the amount column is slightly different. The fastest way to do this is just to head over to Excel. Exercise one. All right, in this exercise, we have a very simple situation. Two short single column lists on the same worksheet. When we're working with two columns we want to compare, they're relatively short and they're on the same worksheet, we can simply select the range and then we go to Home, Conditional Formatting, Highlight Cell Rules, Duplicate Values. And we can identify duplicates, and this means which items are in this range multiple times. In other words, which items are on both lists. We can highlight them in red or yellow or green or any other type of combination you want, but this identifies the duplicates. On the other hand, if we want to see which items are not on both lists, we could simply select Unique. So depending on what you're working on, this may be all you need, but let's go to the next exercise where things get a little bit more complicated. Exercise two. All right, in this exercise, we're dealing with larger lists, multiple columns, and the data might be on two separate worksheets. In this short video, I've included both tables on one sheet just because it's easier to look at, but in practice, these can be on different sheets. So here we have a simple question. Which of these records are also found on this table? The function we'll use in this case is called COUNTIFS, and in essence, it counts the number of matching rows, and we can have one or more conditions, which means we can compare one or more columns. For example, I want to see how many records from table two match all of these three columns, product ID, option, and cost, and I want to put that number right here. So what we do is equals COUNTIFS. Now, these arguments come in pairs. One pair for each condition. For example, count the number of rows where the product ID column, comma, matches our product ID, comma, and where the option column, comma, matches our option, comma, and where the cost column, comma, is equal to our cost. Enter. So what this tells us is that there's one row for AB101 small 8. In other words, this record is also found in table 2. This is found there, and this one is not. This is found, this is not, and you get the idea. And if there were multiple rows that match, this count would include them all. But here's the thing. All of these conditions have to match exactly. For example, what if XY200 small was on table 2 but at a different price? Well, let's take a look. Let's modify this formula and remove the cost condition. Enter. Okay. So what this is telling us is that all of these values are found on table 2, but some of them may not be the exact matching cost. And that brings us to the next exercise. Exercise 3. So instead of counting the number of rows that match, what we want to do is we actually want to retrieve the cost. Now, as a note, if there are duplicate rows in the second table, this function is going to return the sum of all matching rows. But in this case, there's only one match, so this will work in this particular situation. Equals SUMIFS. So we want to sum the cost column, comma, but we only want to include those rows where the product ID, comma, is equal to our product ID, comma, and where the option, comma, is equal to our option. Close the function and hit enter. It is returning the cost when the product and option matches. So in this first case, it's the same price. In the second one, it's the same price, but here it's a different price. So it matches with product and option, but it doesn't match with cost. And now we can easily set up a difference column like equals this minus this. Enter. And so now this is an easy way to quickly identify which costs are different. And we could easily filter this to say, don't show me the ones that match, I just want a list of exceptions. So those are three ways that we can compare two columns. Conditional formatting, that works well when the lists are short and they're on the same worksheet. COUNTIFS, when we're looking at exact matching records. And SUMIFS, if we want to retrieve the sum of all matching rows. Hey, hopefully this helps. Thanks for joining me. Have a great day. Hey, Excel user. If you ever need to create summary reports, check out my Pivot Table for Beginners video. It starts at the beginning and shows how to store the data transactions in a table and then how to summarize those transactions with a Pivot Table report. I hope it helps unlock the incredible power of Pivot Tables.
This video is a production of Excel University.